Okay, I'm gonna send out a link here if I can get one. Two viewers, nice. Not bad. Three. I guess one of those is me though. Sam, you here? Okay. I'm gonna try to send out a link in the chat. Hey, what? Bet. Bet. Yeah, DeMichael's gonna watch, I think. DeMichael or one other. Well, wait, I got another friend watching. So we're not playing in front of no one. Yeah, we're up to four viewers. So it's. Yeah, I've got UFC. Yeah, I got two. I don't play that much, though. Look. I don't, I'm not giving that up. I still play it occasionally, just not much. No. What? Here. Where'd you go? Okay. Inviting to locker room. Okay, please put a comment in the chat if you're viewing this. This way I know who's watching. Yes, like I'm on the mic right now, and I'm, yeah, okay. Trying to get people to actually watch this. Need the publicity for my channel. Yeah, we got like three viewers. Three viewers strong. Five. People are actually watching this. Three again. Yeah, I don't even. We'll get whatever. Andrew, if you're still watching, comment in the chat and I'll make you a mod. Eventually. Oh, you're playing Dirt Rally, okay. Never mind. Sam, you still there? Okay. Let me send you another invite. Invite to game. Yeah, DeMichael sent me a friend request on Twitch, so I guess that means he's watching. My face cam isn't working. Whatever. You want to do a all-star game or something? Thank you. There we go. Okay, start 7. Match. Okay. Five now. I don't know. It's saying five. It's like switching, alternating from like 5 to 3. You wanna do random team? Here. Wait, never mind. I always get the Nets when I do that. I don't know who I wanna be. I hate the Spurs, but I might have to go with them. Yeah, people saw that in the chat. Wait, only 3 people saw the link I sent. But still 2 viewers. Yeah, I know. He does it in the group chat. Coach Williams roast me. Coach Marshall is the only nice one. Okay. Here we go.
On the road looking for a win against a Western Conference rival, the San Antonio Spurs are ready for this thing to get started. We're live in Houston where the Rockets have home court advantage. Thanks for joining us as we get set to... NBA basketball on 2K Sports. Kevin Harlan here alongside Greg Anthony and Chris Webber. DA David Aldridge is on our sideline. And the starting group for the Spurs.
Parker and Green, the tried and tested backcourt. Leonard and Aldridge, the two stars at the three and the four. And it's Gasol at the center filling out the middle. Now, here is Harden. Here's Capella. And the dunk by Capella.
Oh, Capella is just fantastic at dunking at home, leaving no mistake on these kinds of chances near the hoop.
Last season, we had Kobe's retirement, but in the offseason, we said goodbye to another legend, the terrific Tim Duncan. You know, Greg, there was
hanging
up, and he felt that he didn't have any more in him and called it a career after 19 incredible record-breaking seasons.
Yeah, and Timmy retired in the most Duncan way possible, just quietly let it happen in the midst of the summer. No farewell tour or any of that. A big hit to the game of basketball to see one of the all-time greats walk away, but arguably one of the best two-way players to have ever played the game.
Oh, that was the center. Wait, no, that was Ryan Anderson. Never mind.
Off to a good start as he hits his first shot attempt.
Wow, after five shots, they have connected on four of them. Exactly the start they were looking for.
Parker, I don't know what that means, but...
looking to end the run. And the whistle blows, and it's going to be an over-the-back call here.
Yeah, nothing wrong with fighting for the rebound, but he gets nailed with the over-the-back call.
Gordon's checked in for Patrick Beverley. To the paint. And it's sent back by Aldridge. Outside Leonard. Back to Aldridge. And he finishes nicely on the layup.
And now that the seal is broken, maybe their shooting will start to improve.
Great shot right there. More looks should start falling for them now.
No.
Eric Gordon.
Go get that.
One for five to begin this one. Not the start that they wanted.
The three from Harden. The Rockets again can't hit.
There's some defense for you. For someone who's as good at shooting the three ball as he is, you need a defender who's equally good at guarding.
Yeah, I don't think anyone's watching this.
And a little over 2.5 minutes gone here in the first. And stolen by Ariza.
How about the reaction time on that pass? Quick. And what good work there to get in the way of it.
Oh, you love how physical Ariza is. Just attacking the D and earning the call in the process. Kev, whenever I see Trevor Ariza out there, I can't help but think of how he came into the spotlight. He went from being a role player early to becoming a major part of teams after his stint with the Lakers. He said he learned a lot from playing with Kobe.
Wow, what, did he have something in his eye on that shot?
Maybe. Parker kicks to Green. Outside Leonard. Just five to shoot. Out of bounds. Houston takes possession. Rockets leading by eight. Harden outside, pass to Gordon. Harden against Parker, and it's Ariza in the corner. There's the triple. It's rebounded by Leonard. And with Ariza, part of his progression was natural, but he knows that he made a huge jump after he played with Kobe in L.A.
Well, I thought his quote about playing against Kobe was great. I mean, he said, the first time I played against Kobe, he scored 40 on me. The last time I guarded him, he scored 35. So I guess I got a little bit better. You know what? Great sense of humor. Just glad to see it.
Looking for Anderson. He gets it there. Harden against Parker. Anderson with a screen for Harden. A second chance effort. Houston needs to get a shot. And the dunk by Capella.
And they keep going down low with. with the ball and keep getting positive results.
Strategy obvious. Their game plan is to get the ball as close to the basket, and so far it's been paying off extremely well.
And Chris, you're part of perhaps one of the most exclusive clubs in NBA history. You were selected first overall in your draft. What was that like? What an experience that must have been.
Oh, man, it was a wonderful moment. I mean, you know, I worked so hard to get there. I come off of disappointment in college. And so working hard and being able to kind of put that behind you and get right to the next level and be the number one pick, you know, I was just honored. I was thankful. I was humbled. It was just a blessing, you know, and the craziest part about it is that it happened in Detroit at the Palace, where I won 2 state championships there. I won 3 state championships in Michigan and 2 specifically in the Palace at Auburn Hills. And so that place is always going to be special to me. And just growing up and being the number one pick, you know, it was just an honor.
And we see the growth of the three-point shooting big man, the stretch four, if you will. Ryan Anderson was at the forefront, it seems, of that movement.
Yeah, especially at his volume of threes. He's never been just a secondary floor spacer. He's a go-to scoring threat with his outside shooting.
Mills passes to Ginobili. A three-pointer off the mark.
Make shots.
It's Harden with the drive. Here's Nene, and Nene slams it in.
You could not diagram a better way to open a quarter.
It's really the ideal start.
Oh, wow.
Now they have to ride this wave throughout the rest of the game.
I don't know. I just can't play.
1:41 left in the first.
Problem.
Dishes to Deadman.
I can't play in front of people.
Shot clock at 6.
See.
In building this lead, they've done a terrific job finishing their defensive sequences with the backboard. That has been key.
Williams with a clean look. And the wing jumper offline. Anderson wide open. Buries it from 3-point range. Anderson's got his first bucket of the game, and he's on the board for 3. Nene, the screen. Hills with the steal.
Go. Takes so long to run after they get the steal.
Can't hit from 12. Houston leading by 9. Here's Harden. Using his post move to get the 2 points.
It's early, but they are getting pummeled on the glass.
Here's Mills. And the officials whistle a foul on the shot. The bucket's good. He'll go to the line.
And he's really been working to get those looks, and it's starting to pay off here early on.
And the Rockets making a change here. Beverly's checked in. And San Antonio also making a switch. Lee's checked in. Now, here's Beverly. He's been patient so far. Nothing yet on the scoreboard.
And on the glass so far, it hadn't even been close.
2-second difference between...
What? I didn't mean to shoot that.
They get it back. And here's Anderson from the arc. Knocks down the 3 ball. Anderson's got 6. Outside Williams. And Jonathan Simmons gets the whistle that time. That's his first foul.
Nope.
And that concludes the first quarter of play. Houston on top. They lead by 5.
And yeah, we have someone watching this. Never mind, they left.
And now the second quarter just getting set to start.
Nope, now they're back.
And when you consider how the Rockets are doing, guys, you know, what are your thoughts?
It's all about their defense. They have just done a terrific job of negating the timing and spacing of their opponent.
Oh, yeah, great communication. The guys are quick and rotating help and playing with a lot of energy.
On the floor for San Antonio, the defensive duo of Green and Leonard make up the perimeter. David Lee is out there with LaMarcus Aldridge, and it's Murray in at the one spot. And keeping us updated from the sideline, let's swing it over to David Aldridge.
Well, after suffering a hip injury at Texas, LaMarcus Aldridge spent 2 months shooting from a chair, and his form improved dramatically. Now his go-to move is his fadeaway high-release jumper. It's an unstoppable shot, and Aldridge is so confident in it, he says, once the shot's up, I'm getting back on D. Kevin?
Thanks, D.A. He's got a great touch. And Beverly kicks to Capella. And the dunk by Capella. You've played for some legendary coaches, Chris. What do you think is the most important aspect of being a successful coach in college or the NBA today?
Yeah, I don't know if there's one most important, because I think knowledge of the game, I think communicating to your players, I think embracing players, making players better. I think some of the best coaches I've played for have had the smallest of egos, and therefore their guys will run through a wall for them. So I think it takes a lot of different traits to be a great coach in this league, and we've seen some great ones master all the difficult traits in which one needs to have.
That's a great answer.
Yeah, that was the third straight high percentage look the defense has allowed. The defenders have got to start putting bodies on bodies.
Now here's Lee. He's had some playing time.
Dude.
No scoring yet from him.
Another rebound hauled in. They're hitting the glass with a lot of passion.
And it's Beverly missing.
You are shocked when he misses open shots like that. The D should be thanking their lucky stars right now.
And it's Murray with the jam.
And sometimes when you want something done, you got to do it yourself. That dunks the shot in the arm they need to really cut into that lead.
Well, Greg, it certainly got everybody on their bench up and off their seats and cheering.
Well, Kevin, you know momentum is a fickle thing. Sometimes one simple boost in confidence can change the complexion of an entire game.
Beverly, the pass to Nene. Capella. And the dunk by Capella.
Oh, taking it to the rack with power.
Hammering down the two-hand slam. And there's the call on Lewis Williams.
Leonard hasn't scored yet.
James Harden, he's checked in for Houston. Simmons checked in for San Antonio. Parker comes in for Murray. Leonard attacking. Five on the clock. Parker dishes to Leonard. And it's good on the assist by Parker. Leonard's got his first 3 points of the game.
Yeah, the assist by Parker, just brilliant. Really seeing his teammates out there.
Okay. Kicks to Capella. Yes. That's going to be over and back. Not watching for the line.
Yeah, the guy didn't roll.
Beverly again. It's Parker. Out left to the wing. A three from Simmons. Out of bounds. Houston takes possession. And the Rockets have a big fan base in Texas and the surrounding area. There's no doubt. But they also, Chris, have one of the biggest fan bases overseas.
I mean, well, let's be honest. The reasoning for the huge Chinese following, of course, was Yao Ming. Yao was not only an incredible player, but a huge ambassador for the sport and the Rockets. Amazing that his impact and fandom still can be found with the Rockets, even years after his retirement.
Back to Harden. They
get a rebound.
Capella kicks to Nene. Kicks it out to Harden.
Oh, my.
And the three ball is good. Harden's got five.
I was down by 12 and now I'm down by 6. With
their offensive execution.
Parker with it.
Set a screen.
From him, but that's likely to change. Leonard with no.
There we go.
Good, and the assist goes to Gasol.
And they are absolutely.
Who's guarding Harden?
From beyond the arc.
Wasted no time on that one. And it's 8 points for James Harden.
And now he's taken a solid opening in the quarter and built on it here in the second.
There we go. Happy accident.
Rocket lead is cut down now to just 4 points with the basket from Gasol.
What a strong effort. Something I can't say for the defense.
Now, here is Harden. 8 points for him. Houston moving it around. Clock at six. Beverly up top, covered by Parker. Whoops, there's the 24-second shot clock.
The shot clock expired and the ball was in his hands.
For the Rockets, Anderson comes in for Clint Capella, and Eric Gordon subbed in for Trevor Ariza. Then for the Spurs.
Good defense.
Edmonds checked in for Gasol. Kyle Anderson comes in for Leonard. And it's Mills in for Parker. The Rockets have gone 5 of 8 from the floor here in the second quarter. Over 60% shooting. Nene with the screen on Ginobili. And Anderson kicks to Nene. Gordon with no one around. And again, it's the Rockets from deep.
And that's what happens when you have little to no communication defensively. He has the stroke to burn you from out there. Don't you see that?
Fires from deep. Anderson's shot is off.
Not good shot selection. Long range and a defender all up in your jersey.
Well, I'm not even really sure why he even attempted that look. That's a low percentage of shots get.
Mills passes to Dedmon. And he goes up strong with one hand and flushes it down.
And if that doesn't
No, not yet.
Guys, nothing will.
Greg, just what the doctor ordered, huh? Some high-flying antics to narrow the deficit.
Well, also a miscommunication on defense. No one rotates over. See ya.
A much better quarter for them shooting the ball.
And there's the foul. It goes on Ryan Anderson. That's his first foul.
I mean, that's a tough break for the D. I mean, he took the hit and drew the whistle.
Williams, he's checked in for James Harden. Lee's checked in for San Antonio.
What are you?
Green comes in for Manu Ginobili. Here's Dedmon. Again, the miss by the Spurs. And here we go. Fast break. Beverly's got it. Anderson outside. On the wing, Williams, guarded by Green. And Anderson slams it in.
And he can do a lot more damage to the rim than that when he wants
to. Oh, you're right. And with the lead they're enjoying, I'm surprised he didn't put a little something extra on that one.
Yeah, enough scoring on the inside there. I think it's time for him to send a message to his team.
Oh, well, they have to become more physical defensively and really commit to protecting that painted area.
Gotta make my adjustments really quick.
now Mills. With one on the clock. Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give him two chances at the free throw line here. San Antonio shooting their third and fourth free throw shots of the night. And both free throws good for Mills. And the second half about to start here in just a few moments. Spurs trail by seven.
And the continuity for the Spurs, really, it's pretty amazing. I mean, that trio of Parker, Ginobili, and Duncan, the most successful trio in the history of the NBA.
Harden and Ariza, the athletic wing pair. Ryan Anderson out there with Clint Capella. And it's Beverly in at the point. That's the five for Houston right now. And Trevor Ariza is going to pick up a foul here. That's his first foul. A three from Leonard. The rebound by Anderson. Anderson's got his third rebound tonight. And for the Spurs, their star players have all taken less, Greg, in free agency in order to stay in San Antonio.
Yes, burning bigger markets and bigger paychecks. It's a family atmosphere in the Spurs organization. It's rare to see a single player start and finish his career with one team, much less three teammates. And no matter what, one of the big positives they can take away from this game is how well they perform at the line.
And what a tremendous advantage. Bigs who can shoot from the line.
Now, here is Harden. He's got eight. Six on the shot clock. He feeds it to Beverly. From outside the
arc. Oh, come on. I had a hand up.
Good. It's Harden with the assist that time. Harden's got his fifth assist in this one. Aldridge dishes to Parker. Aldridge with his screen on Beverly. Parker drives in. Green kicks to Parker. To the paint. Here's Aldridge. A good finish at the rack off the slick feet. Aldridge has got six.
Great way to start the half. Easy layup against some soft D.
Now, I can tell you this from personal experience, and that's seeing your first shot of the half go in is always a confidence boost. Let's see if they can build on it.
Oh, and the lead gets bigger on a ridiculous offensive sequence.
That dunk alone would have been spectacular. Never mind it coming at the end of an alley-oop. Harden kicks to Anderson. No good on that one. Spurs trail by seven. Oh, and the jam by Leonard.
And maybe that'll trigger them. Impossible.
There we go.
Not to get pumped up after that.
Yeah, well, you could see the immediate reaction of the guys on the bench. They are pumped up.
Yeah, way to get there first and be willing to absorb the contact.
San Antonio making a switch here. Murray's checked in. Gasol is green on Beverly. And play stops. Whistle on what looks to be an illegal screen. Chris, you played for five different teams. How much does the city you live in and call home matter during an NBA season?
Well, it's different for everybody. You know, it's different for everyone. It was great to go home to Detroit for me because I wanted to live and stay in my city. I wanted to eat my mother's cooking before the game. You know, not many times could I do that. You know, I can only do that once or twice or once a year playing on the West Coast. So, you know, those type of things, being close to your family, you know, if you have younger siblings or children, that type of thing, you know, if you have kids with school they go to, you know, I've seen players take and weigh all those things. But for me, I've just been blessed to play in some great places with great fans. Washington, D.C. was a wonderful place. You know, that city really showed us a lot of love as a young team trying to find our way. And then Sacramento, just some of the greatest fans in the world as well, just embracing us. And they had embraced the Sacramento Kings and so many losing.
I gotta do something really quick. I'm gonna see if this works.
Season, so that's just who they
this is how I do good or bad, depending on these adjustments. They're either always good or bad.
People of Sacramento, what they have been waiting for so long, and that's some exciting basketball. And so, you know, the cities that you play for are very important. And me as a fan, you know, I still thank the Bad Boys for how
they
represented the city of Detroit during those years, and Isaiah and Joe Dumars and Bill Laimbeer. So for me, just from a fan perspective, the relationship with the city, the players, is always important.
Well said. Eric Gordon, he's checked in for the Rockets. Williams comes in for Patrick Beverley. San Antonio also making some changes. David Lee checked in for Gasol. Anderson comes in for Leonard.
Oh.
And Simmons subbed in for Parker. Here's Williams after the made shot from David Lee.
I told you
Williams kicks to Capella. And the
I told it to do the exact opposite of what it just did.
Absolutely the prettiest play in basketball executed to perfection.
I don't think you'd get an argument there. Everybody loves the alley-oop. Rockets leading by three.
And after all the dust had settled in the Houston coaching search, the Rockets turned to Mike D'Antoni to take over the reins. Mike D inherits a team that underachieved and is in a bit of a transition phase.
A finish. And then Simmons slams it in.
And talk about putting some extra on it. That dunk was way over the top.
Close game or not, he's going to finish firm when he gets the space. Okay, well, let's check in with David Aldridge, who's recording from the sideline.
Well, guys, Greg Popovich has set the standard with more than 1,500 career victories. Last season, he set the record with his 18th 50-win season, passing Pat Riley and Phil Jackson. Pop told us that, "I've been here a long time, and I've had good players. That's the formula. Getting the players is difficult. I've been fortunate to have good ones." Guys, he's no good now. He knows what makes success.
No, but he can take a lot of the credit regardless, D.A. Thanks. And for the Rockets hiring Mike D'Antoni, they wanted to add
I got lag really bad.
Explosive offense, it seems.
Well, usually you hire a coach that can shore up weakness in a roster. That's not the case for the Rockets and D'Antoni.
There we go.
By any means. They felt going all in on offense was the right move.
San Antonio calls timeout.
And you can tell they're just a little out of sync. I think he just wants to get everybody back on the same page.
Yeah, trying to find their rhythm. It's a chess match, a constant back and forth of in-game adjustments.
And a problem that this Rocket team, Chris, has had to deal with the last few seasons is quitting on themselves during games.
I mean, that's something you have to bring to the table as a player yourself. That's something that is very hard to coach out of a team or prevent because it's all on the mentality of the players. Just mental lapses in general have been a big problem for the Rockets over the last couple of seasons. And it's a shame because they have been so deadly when they all have their heads in the game from start to finish.
Nene, he's checked in for Clint Capella. It's Ariza on the wing. Tries it from 19. Offensive rebound. Outside Williams for three. Gordon rebounded by the Spurs. Anderson passes to Ginobili. Dedmon dishes to Ginobili. With a tie and lots of contact there. Missing the shot. He'll shoot two.
Really, the right play defensively, if you can't block, force them to the line.
The Spurs have been good at the free throw line. This one, 7 of 8.
And when you look at their numbers from a season ago, 80% as a unit, that's something you'll be happy with.
We've got a 9-second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. Back to Williams. And as it goes out of bounds, Houston able to keep the ball here.
And really, no choice but to lunge for that pass to make sure it didn't get through.
Oh, great resolve there on defense, allowing nothing easy.
And Anderson has it in the corner. hits the three-point bomb. Anderson's got 15 points.
See what I'm saying? It's that kind of unfair advantage. It is hype to shoot over guys that well from that deep.
Oh, wow. Okay. So, I don't know.
How about that? Responding to the three-pointer against them.
His three-point bar was really small.
I like that style. Lose 3 points, get them.
It's a tie game here in Houston. And right after this, we'll bring you the start of the final quarter right here on 2K Sports. Welcome back as we get rolling once more. The fourth quarter right ahead in what's been a very well-contested game. Houston's gone downtown 13 times in this game, and they're just over 50%, 7 of 13 on three. On the floor for San Antonio, Mills teams up with Green in the backcourt. Kawhi Leonard is out there with Pau Gasol. And it's Deadman in the pivot spot, manning the middle. Here's Mills. 17-foot shot on the way. That one's in there. Rocket lead is cut to just one on the basket from Deadman.
And defensively, they are on their heels every time the ball comes inside.
For the Rockets, Clint Capella, he's checked in for Nene. And it's James Harden in for Lou Williams. Harden inside the three-point line. Not enough on that one as it misses. San Antonio's gotten the three-point bug tonight. They've taken 15 shots outside the arc. 6 of 15. And he was fouled on the way up. Two free throws now for him. And the Spurs organization, really the gold standard in the NBA. Greg, they just keep winning.
You have to be impressed with how they've acquired young star talent to kind of carry on that tradition. Usually when teams have their stars retire, they go through that rebuild phase. The Spurs only revamp and reload.
Inside, trying to find Capella, gets it to him. Takes the alley-oop pass and dunks it down.
You just love how Harden moves the rock. When a teammate is wide open, he gets it to him so fast.
Pretty much all of their buckets coming from inside the paint now.
And so he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact, and he'll shoot two. And a record-setting year for Harden in 2016, but Chris, not the kind he wanted. He would end up setting the NBA record for most turnovers in a single season with 374. Wow.
That's terrible. But as bad as 374 sounds, it isn't too terrible when you look at the context of what Harden's responsibilities were on that offense. Often he would act as the lone playmaker and be prone to forcing plays. Nevertheless, taking care of the ball is something, and he knows he has to do it.
Oh, come on.
Aldridge. He doesn't hit that one. So Houston will take it the other way.
There we go.
They've held a 12-point lead earlier. Outside, Green. Feeds it to Leonard. And so he draws the foul on the shot. A trip to the line to shoot two.
Well, going into the 2011 draft, the Spurs said it was a tough decision to trade away George Hill in exchange for the pick that became Kawhi Leonard.
How many does Harden have?
Once again, the Spurs struck gold as Kawhi has developed into a true
Sam. Still there.
Now, this game is coming down to the wire, and rush plays like that show how much pressure the players out there really feel.
And we're around 2 minutes into the...
How many points does Harden have?
Gasol is...
No. Okay.
Leonard kicks to Parker. And the wide-open shot from...
Yeah, there was a five-second.
That drops, and it comes off an assist from Parker. Parker's got three assists in the game. And with Kawhi Leonard, who is the high school Mr. California basketball. Interesting to look, Greg, at all the things he's done. Looking back and realize he was only lightly recruited coming out of high school.
Yeah, and he committed early to San Diego State and stuck with them once the bigger schools came calling. The ankles were an issue. I think that might have caused his draft stock to fall a bit in 2011. Only ended up going 15th in that draft. But in hindsight, probably the best player from that class. Mm-hmm.
beautiful execution in terms of creating space for his shot. He just couldn't get that one to fall.
And it goes out of bounds. Last touch by Green. Rockets trail.
Did that get there?
Harden outside. Down low. And the dunk by Capella.
And when the D thinks Harden is going to shoot off the screen and roll, he threads the needle with the perfect pass. What a play.
Parker against Beverly. Now here's Parker. Defense is right there.
Awesome.
Gasol, no good.
As soon as he made his drive to the bucket, the defense jumped right in and prevented him from finishing out.
Gordon, the pass to Harden. Just five on the clock. Oh, and there's the alley-oop. And out of bounds as San Antonio gains possession.
I have no idea why he would have even attempted that. That's a horrible turnover.
And the Rockets making a change here. Ariza's checked in.
Parker. That's not who I meant that meant to pass that to.
Stolen by Harden. It's Anderson with the drive. Capella kicks to Beverly. The dish out to Anderson. And the pass to Harden.
Oh no. Okay. There we go.
Over in the corner, Beverly. That misses. Had a chance to tie it there. Spurs leading by three. Over in the corner, Green. Out to Parker.
Yeah, I should have, but I didn't.
Knocks it loose. And here we go. Beverly heading to the hoop. And the dunk by Capella.
Just phenomenal awareness by Beverly, just dishing the ball to the wide open man easily.
And Aldridge gets it to go on the assist by Parker. And the Spurs lead by three.
Pivotal moment of the game. These guys find the size mismatch for the.
You just now remember you had ice cream out and now it's melting.
His guys were dragging a little bit, calling timeout to kind of let them catch their breath.
Okay.
On the sideline, let's catch up with Hall of Famer David Aldridge.
Kevin, I was able to listen in on what Mike D'Antoni was talking about with his team. He told them, hey, this game is there for you, but we got to go get it. 50-50 balls, get into the basket. We have to give it all right now, Kevin.
Oh, come on.
Much appreciated. That one falls.
Two people contested that.
These shots all the time. Love how he just takes over these possessions.
And Parker, here we go. Here's Aldridge. That drops, and it comes off an assist from Parker. Aldridge has got 10 points here in the second half.
Who's... What the...
Harden against Aldridge. Here's Anderson. Defense.
When did Anderson get so fast?
And that's what Beverly does best, a quick passer who distributes the ball incredibly well.
Now here's Parker.
Roll.
Inside.
Dang it.
And it's the Rockets on the break to take the lead. Out of bounds, Rockets ball as Houston keeps possession. 54 seconds left in the fourth quarter of this one. Anderson passes to Harden. Shot clock at six. Over in the corner, Beverly.
No way.
And the defense from Parker really helps change the direction of the shot, using his speedy hands there incredibly well.
There there's 25 seconds left in the fourth quarter. And there's the call on Patrick Beverley. And that'll be his third foul so far. Gasol is screen on Ariza. And here's Leonard from three.
Oh, wow. I didn't think that was going in.
3-4.
Living for the big moment. His composure in the clutch is phenomenal.
Harden is oh, no.
Point line.
Yes.
Anderson can't get that one to fall. And now they decide to foul intentionally.
Honestly, just doing what they have to in order to get the basketball back.
So he gets them both, and it's a 6-point ball game.
Ooh, a cutthroat effort at the line. That should put this one out of reach.
Harden can't hit. Leonard off on that one. And so it's San Antonio with the win. A narrow win under...
I gotta go to bed.
Is the visiting team.
It really was, but that didn't seem to bother them. I mean...
Yeah, I'm getting kind of tired.
Team, all I know is they were the better team.
Well...
Dang it, I keep saying no to VC. Plus, I might want to stream with... I actually might want to stream with someone else after this. But yeah, thanks for playing. I got that on video. Okay. After the race, of course. NASCAR. Well, thank y'all for watching.